Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. You miss your old familiar friends, but waiting just around the bend. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's you go.
What's up, guys? It's fantastic.
Yesterday.
Oh, gosh,
Rocketman!
What's up, guys? We are seeing Rocketman. We're all super excited. We have like a massive group coming. This actually, if I like have done my math right, this is gonna be like the biggest video I've shot. Died's like Shazam. Actually, it might be more than Shazam. But anyway, we're like super pumped, and we're just chilling in the parking lot of our local movie theater, which is like really good. But I think I see Jackson coming now. So yeah. It's gonna be cool. I don't even remember who's like everyone's coming. So yeah, it's gonna be great. Do you see them? Is that Jackson?
What's up?
Seeing Rocketman, are you excited?
I'm excited.
Are you into Elton John at all?
Yeah, sort of. I'm into the popular stuff. I don't know much of the other stuff, so.
I feel that. A bunch of other people are coming. So yeah, we're just gonna keep chilling here and waiting. Got the waiting game going strong. Hey, yo, what's up, man? Hey, it's Chris. How you doing, bro? It's good to see you. You excited for Rocketman?
Oh, yeah, man.
Sweet. You listen to Elton John at all?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Well, it's going to be great. We're all, like, super pumped. I'm pretty sure I've said that for, like, every little person I've talked to. But we are all just incredibly pumped, and we're waiting for more people. So I just met a subscriber. It was dope, but I didn't record it. It was I thought I was recording and I wasn't. His name was Will.
It was like
Will.
His first time ever meeting
it
a
was.
Fan.
It was, and I totally
he
did.
Had
like,
his phone.
I literally didn't know him. He just drove by because like these guys got here. Brendan, yo, what's up? How you doing? We got Kyle. Hey, bro. I wasn't recording the first time. We already did this. How you doing, Ben? What's up, bro?
My favorite.
Jake, how you doing, bro?
What's up?
What'd you do to your arm?
So where's the cake?
Oh, damn, that sucks. So yeah, we're seeing Rocketman. I recorded this before, but it like didn't work. So are you excited for Rocketman, bro?
Yep.
You are? Okay. Is everyone excited?
I already gave my opinion. Yeah. You'll see it in the video.
Sick,
I was gonna
nasty.
Work it, but it's literally like seven. Hey, Mike!
Are you excited?
I'm very excited. I love Elton John.
I am excited.
Elton John is okay.
That was so robotic, but whatever. Alright, sick. It is official. Everyone is here, I think. Does anyone know if Matt's coming?
He's on.
I don't think Matt's coming. Okay.
He is.
We are going to go see Rocketman. We are pumped, as I said, for like the sixth time. Let's kill this. You guys ready?
I'm ready.
Let's go Rocketman. Yep. We'll see you guys after the movie and give all our thoughts. So let's do it.
So that is a fat boy from nowhere. Get to be a soul man.
Gotta kill the person you were born to be in order to become the person you want to be.
All right, Rocketman, my God, it was absolutely insane. Great movie, obviously. What were your guys' like basic thoughts, like overall, just a general consensus?
Good.
It's great. Yeah.
It was really, really amazing.
It was solid.
Awesome.
Absolutely amazing, man.
Fantastic casting.
Definitely. Who would have thought like Taron Egerton is Elton John? But if he doesn't get an Oscar or at least nominated, like I'm done with the Academy. So Brendan, like, just if you had to give your real quick thoughts, like what would you say about Rocketman?
I feel like the story of Elton John, like it's a real story. It's not like something they made up. It's his story. He helped produce the movie.
Definitely.
I feel that kind of touched my heart more than anything else.
Yeah.
And his songs always hit me.
I need to listen to more of his music because his lyrics, like the woman said in it, are so personal and so real and honest. I'm so excited to listen to it. If you had to give it a quick score, like out of five, or no, out of a letter grade, what would you give it?
I would definitely give it an A+.
A+? That's my man. All right, Ben, what'd you think?
I thought it was a good movie. I mean, like, the kid part's a little bit goofy,
it started
you know.
At 7:30.
Out of 10, I would probably give it an 8.
Eight. Nice, dude.
Yeah?
Sick. What would you give him, man? What did you think? Sorry.
So I gotta agree with Ben. I didn't really like the first half of it. I thought it was cringy with the little kid and then the teen. And the fucking Elvis hair. But other than that, I really like the movie. I knew like most of the songs on there. But yeah, I'd give it probably like an 8 or a 9.
Nice, dude.
Thank you.
It's awesome. Jake, what were your basic thoughts?
But the casting was really good, and that's pretty much it. Other than
that's awesome, dude.
Unnecessary singing.
Did you like it though?
Yeah.
Nice, nice.
I don't really know who Elton John was, but now I know who he is, and he's fucking awesome.
All right, Rocket.
Do I even have to ask?
Okay, so I've been like a huge Elton John fan like my whole life, and like I've known stuff like little details about like behind different songs, and then when they'd show like this movie takes like every single one of his like major songs, like his best songs, and like gives a story behind it. So it's all about the music, it's all about the character and how the different people in his life affect him, and it's just so perfect. I love it.
Sick. What would you give it?
5 out of 5. Taron did amazing. He drove the film. It was beautiful.
Sick, dude. What'd you think, man?
I love the passion from the actor and just the different ways that they showed how like he was going through the motions.
Hey, what's up? Sorry, keep going.
The way that like he was going through life and just like lost and just caught up in the moment, and it really shows that like when he was like getting everything, he was getting nothing, and like the way that like when he was showed that he was just lost, like they like did different like things that were like kind of confusing, but like I don't know, I just loved it so much.
Same, dude. Well, if you had to give it like
5
a
stars. 5 out of 5.
Yes, bro.
5 out of 5.
That's my man.
Look at him.
Yes, that's awesome. The camera might be shaking because I'm shaking because that movie was just so damn incredible. All right, go. Sorry.
So I think that movie was real great. It's just so much, so inspiring, I guess. Like just the comeback story for Elton John. I also Definitely. Think as the token music man in the crowd, the scoring was very well done, and not
yeah,
just like
really.
Not just the Elton John songs, but just like the background music and everything.
Absolutely.
Fit the scene perfectly. It was amazing. Fantastic film out of 10.
That's awesome. That's dude, right here. All right, Michael, thoughts?
Dude, I didn't see it. I fell asleep like 3 times. I don't remember at all like the movie. Like all I know is that like they were singing. I don't like to know the whole thing.
So what'd you actually think?
I don't know. I
did you actually fall asleep?
I fell asleep. Are you? I was so drunk.
Did he fall asleep? Did he actually fall asleep?
I think he may have fell. He left
to go
to the
bathroom. You know why I went to the bathroom, dude? I was so tired. I didn't want you guys to see that I was sleeping, so I like
nap on the freaking toilet.
I knew it. I knew you didn't come back.
I was so tired.
That's what she said.
No, if he fell asleep, it was because of him, not because of the movie.
Yeah, it's not the movie's fault.
I saw you walk by me, and then I swear I didn't see you come back. And I looked.
You know, it's funny because you were gone for a long time. You were gone for a long time, and then when we came outside and I was doing, like, the individual thoughts of people, I asked if I missed anyone, and I saw Jackson, I went over to him, and then you were like, oh, you missed me, but you really didn't have anything to contribute to the film at all.
I also really liked how, you know, at the beginning it came with him, like, going into rehab, and, well, just, like, talking, and, like, how at first it like seemed like it was like all a dream in his head, but when it came full circle, he was really like experiencing like that like conversation and how he actually like dealt with the people in his life and the problems he's had with them individually. And how it came full circle from like when he like first started making songs, you know, like listening to me and doing it, and then like looking at the lyrics and like starting to do it, and like just how it came full circle is just, I really like that.
Definitely. It was just so, it's so well done, so creative, so just, it's beautiful. If I could sum it up in one word, it's
fucking tastic.
Yes. One of those movies that's very, such a personal film. It's very, very special to me. I'll never forget this experience. And I want to thank you guys. It's actually my birthday today. I want to thank you all.
Thank you very much. Right. Before we end this video off.
What's up?
Kyle, go ahead.
Man, you guys are absolutely incredible. Seriously, the podcast. It's a glow-in-the-dark LED nightlight narwhal. Can you
believe
that?
These are glow-in-the-dark too. They're mine.
Oh, yeah. Yours, thank you. And then, of course, the Minecraft calendar for 16 months.
16 months on this baby.
So, yeah, we're in my room. This actually happened after we saw, like, Rocket Man. Real quick, you got me something, and you really wanted me to film it and see it, so you got me.
You want to show it? You want to show it to the camera?
Victoria's Secret.
Oh man.
So, thank you so much, dude. He got me Demolition on Blu-ray, which is one of my favorite films that you showed me. Oh, Gag. It says Gag. Okay. So this is like a very personalized gift with like lots of inside jokes. But so you actually showed me Demolition. It's like one of my favorite movies now. You wrote Gag. So seriously, thank you. Gyllenhaal's fantastic. And then this one, which I haven't seen, but I've always wanted to. It's, I think it's Danny Boyle. Yeah. James Franco, who I'm like a huge fan of. 127 Hours. And it says Meat.
Oh, it goes meat, so meat gag.
Meat gag. And then...
and he's 18 now. Keep that in mind.
Yes, so. I just turned 18. And he gave me a $1 bill with a little sticky note on it that says, this shall be your first stripper, Washington. Chris.
Use it wisely.
Gamble now that you're 18. The dice. Thank you, bro.
Just like Joseph Gordon-Levitt's Inception.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, now we're gonna head back to us in the parking lot. But seriously, thank you.
Yeah.
Really awesome. See you guys there.
So Rocketman was amazing, obviously. That's gonna end the video, guys. Seriously, thank you so much. For all coming out here, I really couldn't have asked for anything else for my 18th. So seriously, thank you so much, all of you. And guys, I want to thank you for watching this video. It's been one hell of a time to make. It's so fun doing this, and I'm gonna keep doing this for as long as I can. Seriously, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a like. If you saw Rocket Man, let me know what you thought. If you liked it, you didn't like it, comment down below. I always get back to you guys. And make sure to subscribe. That way, I can see you guys next time. Peace.
Bye, y'all.
Peace. Yeah.